All right, welcome to Voodoo Chronicles. I am Wunam, aka Nicky Love, your African indigenous traditional healer. And we all know, what does voodoo mean? Voodoo means spirit. And here we have another special guest today who will let you know her voodoo story, or her spirit story, or her most scariest story. Yes. Okay, so I want you to introduce yourself to the listening audience.
Hello, I am Lonnie, and I am her son's girlfriend. I live right downstairs, so my experience happened right downstairs. I was actually having a dream, and in my dream, I saw this black, dark figure with glowing yellow eyes. And when I woke up, I saw the same figure in my corner, in the corner of my room, by my dresser. And I looked over and I was scared, but I didn't want to show it any fear. So I just looked over and then I looked away and I kind of just laid down on Paul. And I asked him if he saw what was in the corner and he said no. So I was like, okay, it's only me. I looked over again. He was still there. And then it's like he completely disappeared. And then I saw him in the next corner of our room.
So he moved to another corner?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He had moved right behind Paul. And at this point, I had like jumped back and Paul was like, what is wrong with you? And I was like, you don't see that right behind you? And he was like, no, I don't see anything. So I started to bury myself in his chest. And literally, I felt it like come to my side of the bed and it was breathing on the back of my neck.
Oh, really? So didn't you say that it was yelling or something?
Yeah, in the corner, it was yelling at me. And it was, I can't remember now what he was saying to me, but it scared me. It scared me. I've seen spirits since I was little, and I was tormented by them when I was little, and he was kind of doing the same thing, like trying to taunt me, just trying to yell things at me that I already know that I'm battling with, and trying to scare you. And I was really trying not to show it any fear. I was trying not to look at it or anything like that, but when I felt him breathe on my neck, I was scared.
So I was scared. So what did Paul do? Did
Paul, he was pretty calm. He doesn't get scared about things like that. But I don't get how he's just so calm. He tries to calm me down and everything. But I was just like, I don't understand how I was crying. I didn't understand how he didn't
so
see it.
So it scared you that bad?
Yeah.
It made you cry?
Yeah.
So he must have been saying some really bad thing.
Yeah.
And then the breathing on the back of your neck.
It literally gave me chills. Like my whole body tensed up. I could feel it. Like just chill my spine. And I knew he was a negative entity,
like
because very bad. Because I could feel his energy.
Especially if he was yelling at you, telling you all kind of things. So tell me this. Now you said when you were a little girl you had some problems. So tell me, did you see that spirit before?
I haven't seen him before, but they used to appear as my mom or Roxy as little kids.
They would come in different forms.
Yes,
because you know and demons could do that. They can change and make you think.
I didn't know what they were until I was older, but literally it would me mom like coming in the bathroom. Like I'd be using the bathroom, and it'd be like mom coming in the bathroom and I think it's really her, but it's not. And it starts to distort its face, like starts melting off, and then it starts screaming and just running up to you like creepy ways. Like, you know how in the movies they crawl really weird? They used to do that to me. Like in the bathtub, they would peek through the little shower curtains and stuff like that. And I would come in and I would look. They would come as clowns sometimes to me. I had a very, very bad like phobia of clowns when I was little.
So the demons fed off of your fear.
Yes.
So then they would come to you and appear as clowns.
Yes.
Wow.
Like I had my aunt Jelana. We went to her apartment one day, and she had clowns all in her bathroom. But it was like I felt this weird energy, and ever since that day, I did not like clowns at all. Like I don't play with clowns. I've never liked. Any birthday party, you will see me back up. I don't like clowns.
Wow.
I don't like them.
Well, that's because the demons were coming in the form of clowns because they knew that's what you feared. And that's what they do. You know, and people need to, and it's good that people hear stories like this because some people have the same experiences and they don't understand that these demons, they shapeshift and they can come to you as a loved one and you think it is your mother and then they obviously you see the face change. See, these things are real.
Those, and yeah. that I will say is the scariest thing. When you think that it's one of your loved ones and it's not, they have a very good way of like forming themselves just to talk like them, to act like them, and then out of nowhere they do something or they say something where you know it's not that person.
Right.
Like it's scary. It's a very scary experience. Trust me, it's not anything that anyone wants. It's very scary.
And see, it's good again because people have to understand this stuff is real. And this is why we're doing Voodoo Chronicles, because people have experienced what Lonnie has experienced and people think they're crazy and they're not. This is real.
Okay. The last time I saw a spook when I was younger, I didn't see one until I was 13. Uh-huh. But when I was younger, I smacked myself into a wall. I was running away from one of them. And I literally smacked myself into a wall and I never...
So what do you mean you was running? What did you see? Tell me what happened.
Things were, I was in the bathroom. Mom was coming in the bathroom and I can remember her. She came in there, but I couldn't see her really. I was looking at the demons. They came in the bathroom with her and they were like, I'm going to kill your mom. I'm going to kill her. Watch me kill her. Wow. And they're behind my mom and my mom is talking to me and screaming at me and shaking me, but I can't hear her and I can't really feel myself. I went numb. I'm listening to everything that the demon's telling me and she's not understanding because she can't see into the spiritual world like me. So it was very scary because I was trying to tell her to move and she wasn't understanding. Like I was trying to protect her and they're coming at her and me and I was screaming and I started crying. It's giving me chills.
Yeah, because you're thinking about it.
But it literally was, that was one of the worst experiences. When they come as your loved ones and they come in with your loved ones, Roxy used to get sleep paralysis, they call it, but I know it was a sleep demon. And it used to come on top of her all the time. When we were little, I would literally have to wake up out of my sleep because I would hear her grunting. She couldn't scream, you can't talk or anything, so I would hear her grunt, you know? And I would literally, once it started happening, quite a few times, I could wake myself out of my sleep. And I would jump on top of her and knock the demon off and stay on top of her because I was not playing that. I do have fear, but I don't show them fear.
You can't, because otherwise then they'll do what they did to you. They'll show themselves, they'll keep appearing and doing things like that. You tell them, get out of here. That's what you do.
And Auntie Dee Dee has taught me that and it has worked. Trust me, if you don't think that your words have power, you are a living thing. You have more power than whatever it is. Trust me. I've had more experiences with a white witch that is down in our room. She comes and the other day she moved my blanket down while I was sleeping and I told her to get out the room. Cause
she did? What did she look like?
She was white. She black hair, older looking, very, very old.
Like maybe 70 years old, something like that?
Yeah, around there. Oh, okay. She don't look evil, but you can just tell her energy is very evil.
So she pulled the covers down?
Yeah, I was by my bed, and I just felt the covers go like this. And I was like, lady, you need to leave the room, and you need to do it now. Because,
So you think it's someone that used to live in this house?
Yes, I do.
Yeah?
I do.
Yeah.
Okay. She's in there a lot, and she's in the closet a lot. She plays with my hangers and she plays with my clothes while she's in my closet.
I hear her.
I hear her.
Tell her to get her behind out of here.
When I do, I always tell her, get out. Like, what are you doing in here? I'll open my window, I'll cleanse my room out, I'll get my crystals out, and I'll play like a frequency or something.
So I wonder if she has something to do with this house, because I know that the owners used to be, they were Caucasian before, and I don't know if she had, maybe it was a mother or something, because I actually seen that woman that you're talking
and
about.
Then Lisi, she said when she stayed in the room too, she felt like it was, and our room is always like colder than usual, like I can tell when something is in there because it gets really cold, like unbearable, and it happens a lot in our room. Like I don't feel it too much, and I don't know. It's not as bad sometimes, but then some days I walk in and I feel her.
Okay. Well, we got to get her out of here. We got to smoke that room out again and put some herbs in there. But I want to thank you for joining us here on Voodoo Chronicles.
Thank you for having me.
Okay. Family, another great show, another great guest, and another great scary story. So until next time, we'll see you on Voodoo Chronicles. Blessings. To be a special guest on Voodoo Chronicles, please call 909-749-8626.